Here, all students, yesterday we have done, we have seen how to do operation of polynomials, and also we have solved some solved examples from textbook, page number 41 and 42, all the solved examples we have solved. We have started practice set 3.2, so let's revise what we have done yesterday. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division was pending, okay? So practice set 3.2, you can see the first question was, use the given letters to write the trees every year by B, then how many trees will there be after X years? Okay, so you can see, I just gave you an example yesterday. If 2 is added to 5 times 3, so how you will write this expression? It should be written as 2 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. If you will use some technique or some ideas, you can see this can be written as 2 plus 3 multiplied by 5. Fine. So how to write 2 plus 3 multiplied by 5? That means it is, the answer will be 2 plus 3 multiplied by 5 is 15. That is 17. Okay, you will get the answer. So here the question was, there are 8 trees. So instead of 8 trees, here 2 trees were there. Instead of A, I have seen taken 2 trees. Instead of B, I have taken 3. And instead of X years, this is X years. 3 multiplied by 5. 5 times 3 is 3 multiplied by 5 is 15. So it can be written as, the expression can be written as using A, B and X. A plus 5 times X times B. That means A plus B plus B plus B plus B, X times is there. What is this X? X is, we don't know what is, how much is X. Okay, it can be any number. And every year it is increasing by B. The trees are increasing by B. So it will be written as A plus B X times. B X times can be written as B X. So the expression can be written as A plus B X. So your answer you can write directly also, or you can write the steps also. Okay. See the next one. Next question was, so the answer set should be written as, you can see here, number of trees in the beginning, it was A. Number of trees every year's increment was B. And number of trees X years will be written as BX years. BX. Okay. So the total number trees after X years will become A plus BX. This can be, this answer should be written as this, in this way also. And you can write in two steps also. If it is for 1 mark, the answer can be written as in this, in the first one step. Okay. If it is for 2 marks, you have to elaborate your answer in this way. You have to explain your answer and write in this way. Okay. The next question is, for the parade, there are Y students in each row and X such rows are formed. Then how many students are there for the parade in all? So let's start with, see here, I have drawn 3 columns and 4 rows. Fine. 3 columns and 4 rows can be written as 3 multiplied by 4. 3 multiplied by 4 means 3 multiplied by 4 is 12. So number of students are 12. Okay. So for the parade, there are Y students. Y students means these are the students and these are the rows. Fine. 3 students in each row. In X such rows. So there are 4 rows and 3 students in each row. So it can be written as 4 multiplied by 3 equal to 12. How you will find out the number of students? If number of students increase and X such rows increase, we will not be able to find out the number of students. So you have to use this formula, X multiplied by Y. Okay. So number of students in each row is Y. And total rows are X. So total students will be total rows multiplied by number of rows in each row, number of students in each row. You can see here, this way you have to write the answer. Total rows are x and number of students in each row is y. So therefore, xy is the total student. Fine. So the answer is there are xy students in all for the parade. Our next question is, the tens and unit place of a two-digit number is m and n respectively. Write the polynomial which represents the two-digit number. Here you can see if the number is 73. I have taken an example, 73. 73 can be written as 7 multiplied by 10. Here, at the place, and at the place of unit, there is 3. 3 multiplied by 1. So your answer will be 7 multiplied by 10 plus 3 will be 70 plus 3. 70 plus 3 will become your number as 73. So if you will take for two-digit number, if you will take any variable as m and n, for tens place you will take m and for unit place you will take n. So your number will become, this way you have to write, 7 is your m and 3 is your n. So you can write m multiplied by 10 plus n multiplied by 1. This way you have to write your expression. So your two digit number will become 10m plus n. Digits in 10th place is equal to m. Digits in unit place equal to n. Two digit number is equal to 10 multiplied by digit in 10th place. And plus 1 multiplied by digit in unit place. So it will become 10 multiplied by m plus 1 multiplied by n. So the answer will be 10m plus n. So the polynomial representing the two digit number is 10m plus n. This way you have to write the answer. This is your final answer. Okay. See properly. You can take the screenshot. This is very important for your 10th standard. There are word problems which is related to digits in two-digit number. And after interchanging the number, it will become 10n plus m. This way, these types of questions will come in your 10th standard. So keep this in your mind. Our next question is, add the given polynomial x cube minus 2x square minus 9. 5x cube plus 2x plus 9. So how we have to do the addition? Write both the polynomials in bracket. Open the bracket. No need to change the sign because addition, we are doing addition. Fine. Now keep the like terms together. X cube plus 5x cube minus 2x square is alone plus 2x minus 9 plus 9. This way you have to write the next step. Then you can see here plus 9 and minus 9 will get cancelled, or you can see that the answer is 0 here. And my answer is 6x cube. X cube plus 5x cube will become 6x cube minus 2x square plus 2x. So your answer is 6x cube minus 2x square plus 2x is the final answer for your addition of these two polynomial. Next question is minus 7m raised to 4 plus 5m cube plus root 2 and 5m raised to 4 minus 3m cube plus 2m square plus 3m minus 6. So if you will do the addition vertically, you have to keep all the like terms together. Okay. So we will do the vertical addition. So it will be easy for you to not to convert it into general form or standard form. Fine. So you will keep this in bracket, then open the bracket as it is. Then keep the like terms together. 7m minus 7m cube plus 5m raised to 4. It is written in pink. Plus 5m cube minus 3m cube. Then what is remaining? 2m square plus 3m plus root 2 minus 6 are written over here. So what you'll have to do here, only you have to add this, add or subtract this. You will get the answer. Minus 7 plus 5 is minus 2m raised to 4. 5 minus 3 is 2m cube plus 2m square plus 3m plus 2 minus 6. This is your final answer. Where you will get stuck and you will not get any like terms to add or subtract over here. So you have to keep the answer as it is, and this will be your final answer. Fine. We'll see the next question. Third one, 2y square plus 7y plus 5, 3y plus 9, and 3y square minus 4y plus minus 3. Here, two trinomial and one binomial is there. Three polynomials are there. Okay, so we will do the horizontal addition. You can see here, this is written over here in bracket. This one is here and third one is here. Open the bracket as it is, you can see here. Then keep the like terms together. 2y square. Where is the like term? 3y square. Plus 7y. Plus 3y. Minus 4y. All the like terms are together. And all the constants plus 5 plus 9. And minus 3 is here. So start addition or subtraction. 2y square plus 3y square is 5y square. 7y plus 3y is 10y. 10y minus 4y is 6y. Okay. 5 plus 9 is 14. 14 minus 3 is 11. So your final answer is 5y square plus 6y plus 14. Fine. This is your final answer. Now the next question is subtract the second polynomial from the first. X square minus 9x plus root 3 and minus 19x plus root 3 plus 7x square. So you have to do the subtraction. You don't need to write it in standard form if you are doing it horizontally. Okay, so write these terms, this polynomials in bracket. Fine. First bracket will not change its sign. Only second bracket ka sign change karna hai humko, second polynomial ka. So here you will write this as it is. X square minus 9x plus root 3 minus plus root 3 minus minus 19x will become plus 19x. Plus root 3 will become minus root 3. And plus 7x square will become minus 7x square. Fine. So your next step will be this one. Fine. You can see the next step. You have to keep the like terms together. You can see x square and minus 7x square is there. Minus 9x plus 19x plus root 3 and minus root 3 is there. So after doing this addition or subtraction, x square minus 7x square will become minus 6x square. Minus 19 plus 9 will become 19 minus 9, that is 10x. And plus root 3 and minus root 3 will get reduced from here. So your answer is minus 6x square plus 10x. Fine. Our next question is 2ab square plus 3ab a square b minus 4ab. 3ab minus 8ab square plus 2a square b. So you keep this two polynomials in bracket, then open the bracket, the sign will get changed. 2ab square plus 3a square b minus 4ab will become as it is. Minus plus 3ab, minus 3ab may convert ho jayega. Minus 8ab square will become plus 8ab square. Plus 2a square b will become minus 2a square b. Fine. Now you have to keep the like terms together. 2ab square plus 8ab square, then 3a square b minus 2a square b, then minus 4ab minus 3ab. Fine. We'll see the next step. We have written over here. Our next step is add this. You will get 2 plus 8, 10ab square 3 minus 2, 1a square b, minus 4 minus 3, minus 7ab. So this is your final answer. Now next question is, multiply the given polynomial. Sorry. 2x is monomial and x square minus 2x minus 1 is your trinomial. Okay. So you have to multiply monomial with trinomial. So let's start with the multiplication. 2x is multiplied by this polynomial. So you have to write the second or first, whatever it is. You have to keep it in bracket, round bracket. Okay. Then 2x multiplied by x square minus 2x into 2x minus 2x into 1. You can see here, each term is multiplied with the second polynomial. 2x multiplied by x square is written over here. Then 2x multiplied by minus 2x is written over here. So minus 2x into 2x is written over here. Then 2x multiplied by minus 1 is written over here. So it will become minus 2x. Fine. The sign gets changed. Minus 2x or plus 2x will be minus 2x. And here we see minus 1 multiplied by 2x is minus 2x into 1. Okay. Next step. 2x multiplied by x square. You can see here. X is to 1 into x square will become x cube. Then 2x multiplied by 2x is 2x into 2 is 4. Already minus is there. X multiplied by 1 multiplied by x multiplied by 1 will become x square. Fine. Minus 2x multiplied by 1 will become minus 2x itself. Fine. This is your final answer. You can see this index rule we have used, a raised to m multiplied by a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. Next question is x raised to 5 minus 1, x cube plus 2x square plus 2. This is more binomial and this one is trinomial. Okay. So this multiplication will become slightly big. So I have to add, you have to multiply x raised to 5 with the second polynomial whole. And minus 1 with the, again, second polynomial. Okay. So let's see the next step. X raised to 5 multiplied by x cube plus 2x square plus 2. It should be written in brackets again. Fine. Next is minus 1 multiplied by x cube plus x 2x square plus 2. So this way you will get two brackets over here. And you have to open this again. Okay. Now you can see this is monomial is there, this trinomial is there. This is monomial, this is trinomial. So it can be easy to calculate. Next step, you can see x raised to 5 multiplied by x cube, x raised to 5 multiplied by 2x square, then x raised to 5 multiplied by 2. That is 2x raised to 5. The next is minus 1 is there. So you can see only sign will get changed. Minus 1 into x cube, minus 1 into 2x square, minus 1 into 2. Fine. Our next step is, after doing all this multiplication, you will get x is to 8 here over here. X is to 5 into 2x square, 2x is to 7, plus 2x is to 5. 1 into x cube is x minus x cube, minus 1 into 2x square is minus 2x square, minus 1 into 2 is minus 2. Here you can observe in the last step, x is to 8, x is to 7, x is to 5, x is to 3, x square minus 2. No like terms are there. So your answer will be as it is. And this is your final answer. Fine. We'll see the next question. 2y plus 1 multiplied by y square minus 2y cube plus 3y. So here, again, the same method which we have done in second sum. Let's see here, 2y plus 1 multiplied by y square minus 2y cube plus 3y. 2y multiplied by this polynomial written in bracket plus 1 multiplied by y square minus 2y cube plus 3y is written over here in the bracket. Okay. 2y multiplied by y square will become 2y cube. Then 2y multiplied by minus 2y cube is written over here. Then 2y multiplied by 3y is written over here. Then plus 1 is multiplied by the whole term. will become as it is, but I have shown you 1 multiplied by y square, minus is there, so minus will be written over here, minus 1 multiplied by 2y cube, plus 1 multiplied by 3y is plus 3y, fine. So here you can see only one like term is there, this will become 2y cube, this will become minus 4y raised to 4, this is 6y square plus y square minus 3y cube plus 3y. So we will write in standard form or in decreasing order, minus 4y raised to 4 is here, plus 6 plus 1 is plus 7y, plus 2y cube and minus 2y cube will get reduced. That means 0 will come here, plus 3y is pending. Fine. So your answer is, final answer is minus 4y raised to 4 plus 7y square plus 3y. Okay, now let's proceed to division. Practice set 3.2, question number 5, divide first polynomial by second polynomial. That means your first polynomial will be your dividend and the second polynomial will be your divisor. Write the answer in the form of dividend is equal to divisor multiplied by quotient plus remainder. So your question is x cube minus 64 and x minus 4. So let's start. Here you have to write in this way, as you always do the division in this way. So we will do the same method. You can see if 8 is divided by 3, we write 8 over here and 3 here. Then 3 twos are 6 will come and we write here. And after doing subtraction, you get 2 over here. This 2 is your remainder and this 2 is your quotient. This is your divisor and this is your division. Fine. So this way you have to find the values. So two things you already have, divisor and divisor. You have to find quotient and remainder. So let's solve one previous question. Easy question. Okay. Then we will proceed to the first question. Here the y square plus 10y plus 24 is divided by y plus 4. See the steps and explanation over here. Y is divided, y square is divided by y. Or else you can say which number should be, which variable should be multiplied by y to get y square. So you can say that y multiplied by y, we get y square. So y square, if we want y square, we have to multiply y with y. But 4 should be also multiplied by y so that we can do the multiplication of monomial with binomial. What is your monomial? Your monomial is y. And it should also be multiplied by 4 also so that we can get y square plus 4y, and which will be written over here. Under y square plus 10y. You can see it properly. It should be written over here. So after doing subtraction, you can see y square minus y square will get reduced, plus 10y minus 4y. The sign gets changed. You are doing operation of subtraction. Don't get confused. You can write it in the left side, round into the round bracket. 10y minus 4y will become 6y. And this 24, you have to write next to 6y. The next 6y plus 24 is there. So you just have to see y should be multiplied by which number to get 6y. So y should be multiplied by 6 to get 6y. Then again, you have to multiply 4 with the same number 6. You get 24. So you will get 6y plus 24, and 6y plus 24 should be written over here. 6y plus 24, you can see the sign gets changed. You are doing operation of subtraction. Plus 6y minus 6y will get reduced. Plus 24 minus 24 will get reduced. Your remainder will be 0. So your quotient is y plus 6 and your remainder is 0. So now the same method you have to follow for x cube minus 64 and x minus 4. Your x minus 4 will become as it is, but x cube minus 64 ko tumko standard form mein convert karna padega. So we will see the first step. What you'll have to do here, x should be multiplied by which polynomial to get x cube. So x should be multiplied by x square to get x cube. So same way, minus 4 also should be multiplied by x square. Fine. So next step is minus 4 should be multiplied by x square equal to minus 4x cube square. So this x cube minus 4x square should be written under x cube minus 64. So here you can see x cube can be written in under x cube and signs will get changed and it will get reduced. But under this minus 64, can you write minus 4x square? No, because we should get like terms under that, above that number. Okay, so you have to convert this number, polynomial in standard form. You can see over here, it is converted in standard form. X cube plus 0x square plus 0x minus 64. As this we have done in practice set 3.1. So we will convert this into standard form. After writing this way, you can see this x cube minus 4x square can be written over here. Minus 4x square. And x cube minus x cube will get reduced. And this 4x square will come over here. Okay. See the next step. Here you can see. So your answer. Next step will be. You can see x cube will get reduced. 0 plus 4. Minus 4 will become plus 4. So it will become 4x square. And you will write 0x next to 4x square. Take it down. 4x square plus 0x. Now, x should be multiplied by which number to get 4x square? So x should be multiplied by 4x to get 4x square. So minus 4 also should be multiplied by 4x. So you can see 4 minus 4 should be multiplied by 4x. We'll get minus 16x. 4x square minus 16x we will write over here under 4x square plus 0x. Now we will do the subtraction. You can see after doing subtraction, 4x square minus 4x square will get reduced. 0x minus 16x was there. But after getting sign change, you will get plus 16x over here. And write this minus 64 next to 16x. That means it will become 16x minus 64. Now what you'll have to do, you have to find x should be multiplied by which number to get 16x. You will see x multiplied by 16 is 16x. So minus 4 also should be multiplied by 16. You will get 60 minus 64. You get 16x minus 64 and it should be written under 16x minus 64. This one. Fine. We will see the steps. You can see here. After doing this subtraction, sign gets changed. Plus 16x minus 16x will get reduced. And minus 64 plus 64 will get reduced and you will get the remainder as 0. So your dividend is x cube minus 64 and divisor is x minus 4. Your quotient you have to write this over here. Every number which you have multiplied by the divisor should be written over here. Every polynomial, okay? So your polynomial of quotient is x square plus 4x plus 64 and remainder is 0. And it should be written in the form of quotient is equal to x square plus 4x plus 16 and remainder is equal to 0. Now dividend is equal to divisor multiplied by quotient plus remainder is equal to, can be written as x cube minus 64. You can see here, this x cube minus 64 should be written over here. And divisor is x minus 4. Your quotient is x square plus 4x plus 16 multiplied by plus 0 is your remainder. You say you have to write this in this formula. Now let's proceed to next question. only two questions are there as we have done in page number 42. 2 plus 2x square divided by x plus 2. This division method is there, but linear method of division is not there. Now, we will divide this 5x cube raised to 4 plus 4x raised to 4 minus 3x cube plus 2x square plus 2. It's already there in standard form and you just have to divide it. You don't need to convert divisor into standard form. It is already there in standard form, but divisor is constant is remaining, but no need to write the constant. Okay. See the next step. Sorry. Pi x cube. Pi x is 2 5 plus 4x is 2 4 minus 3x cube plus 2x square plus 0x is 2 1 is left. And plus 2x is 2 0 can be written as it is 2. So after writing in the division form, you can see we have to find out the quotient x square should be multiplied by which polynomial to get pi x is 2 5. So you can do it in this way also, pi x is 2 5 divided by x square. So you get x square, I have to 2x will get cancelled. We'll get pi x cube, fine? So you get pi x cube. And pi x cube should also be multiplied by minus x, because here we have x square minus x. X square minus x is there. So pi x cube should be multiplied by minus x, you will get minus pi x is to 4. So plus pi x is to 5 minus pi x is to 4 should be written over here, under pi x is to 5 plus 4 x is to 4. You see the next step? It will be written over here in this way, 5x is to 5 minus 5x is to 4. After doing subtraction, the signs get changed, you will get plus 5x is to 4 will get reduced, and plus 4x is to 4 plus 5x is to 4 will become 9x is to 4. And you have to write this minus 3x is to 3 next to 9x cube, 9x is to 4. Now you will see 9x is to 4 minus 3x is to 3. Now, to get 9x is to 4. This 5x cube we have written over here. You have to write simultaneously this quotient also, 5x is to 4. Now, 9x is to 4. X square should be multiplied by which number to get 9x is to 4? We get 9x is to 2. The same number should be multiplied by minus x to get your polynomial to do the subtraction, right? You can see minus x get multiplied by 9x square, you get minus 9x cube. This should be written in under 9x is to 4 minus 3x cube. 9x is to 4 minus 9x cube will be written over here. See the next step this way, okay? So here 9x is to 4 minus 9x is to 4 will get reduced, and here sign gets changed. Minus 9x will become plus 9x. Plus 9x minus 3x will become 6x cube. So here you have got plus 6x cube. Now to get plus 6x cube multiplied by x square, what we will get here? X square should be multiplied by which number to get 6x cube? 6x. Okay. So x square multiplied by 6x, we will get 6x cube. So minus x should also be multiplied by plus 6x. We get minus 6x square. This 6x will go to the place of quotient. Already we have written plus 5x cube plus 9x square. Now 6x will be written over here. Okay. Now 6x cube minus 6x square will be written over here. And this 6x should be written over here. This way you have to do the step by step. After doing the subtraction, we will get 6x cube minus 6x cube reduced plus 2x square plus 6x square will become 8x square. Now x square should be multiplied by which number to get 8x square, this one. Okay, this, to convert this into this, we have to multiply it by 8, and this 8 should be written over next to 6x, okay, as a place of quotient. And minus x also should be multiplied by 8, we get minus 8x. 8x square minus 8x we will write over here, and this 8 we will write over here. See the next step. You can see here we have already written 8 over here as the place of quotient, and 8x square minus 8x is written over here. After doing the subtraction, we get 8x square minus 8x square cancelled, plus 0x plus 8x will become 8x. Anything else we can do over here in this subtract division? Nothing. So you will write plus 2 next to, I cannot write over here. Plus 2 next to, this plus 2 is remaining. This plus 2 you have to write over here in next to 8x plus 2. So your quotient is 5x square, 5x cube plus 9x square plus 8x, 6x plus 8. And the remainder is 8x plus 2. These two things are very important. After this, you can write in this form, dividend is equal to divisor multiplied by quotient plus remainder. So your answer is 5x is to 5 plus 4x is to 4 minus 3x cube plus 2x square plus 2 equal to, I will zoom out and show you, is equal to x square minus x. This is your divisor, and your quotient should be written over here. 5x cube plus 9x square plus 6x plus 2, and 8x plus 2 is your remainder. This way you have to write the answer. Now, question number 6 from practice set 3.2 is reduced from your portion. Our next topic is synthetic division. Just have a look how to do the synthetic division. And in 3.3 also, I will just do some examples, solid examples in front of you. To do synthetic division, there are some steps to get followed. And it's quite easy, but steps should be followed step by step, and it should be proper. And signs should be used properly. We know how to divide one polynomial by other polynomial. We have done it in division of polynomials. Now we will learn an easy method for division of polynomials when divisor is of the form of x plus a or x minus a. The divisor should be in the form of x plus a or x minus a. Just keep it in your mind. Keep it in your mind if the divisor is in the form of x plus a. That means coefficient of x should be 1. And constant should be any number. Okay. And it should be a binomial. Fine. So divide the polynomial 3x cube plus 2x square minus 1 by x plus 2. So here, let us write the dividend polynomial in the coefficient form. First of all, in the division method also, you have to do the same thing. And in this synthetic division also, you have to do the same thing. In this form of the dividend polynomial is 3x cube plus 2x square minus 1. Will become 3x cube plus 2x square plus 0x minus 1. X is missing. Don't forget that. You have to write 0x minus 1. Now write coefficient form of the given polynomial. Now to write in coefficient form, you have to start with round bracket, then coefficient of each term. 3, 2, 0 and minus 1. Separated by comma and round bracket close. This is your coefficient form. Now let us use the following steps for synthetic division. Our first step Just 1 minute. Let us use the following steps for synthetic division. Draw. First step is draw one horizontal line and vertical line as shown below. You can see here. You have to draw one vertical line and one horizontal line in this way. Okay? And there should be place for first row, second row and third row as it's shown over here. First row, second row and third row. So that you can write the numbers over here. Just have to do the vertical line and horizontal line and you're done. It's not like that. There should be place for first row and second row and third row to write over here. Okay. Our next step is divisor is x plus 2. As you can see here, divisor is x plus 2. Hence, take opposite number of 2, which is minus 2. You can see here, x plus 2, you can write in this way also, x plus 2 equal to 0. So, x equal to minus 2. This minus 2, you have to write over here. Okay? So, write minus 2 to the left of the vertical line. As shown, I told you, in the first row. Write the coefficient form of the dividend polynomial in the first row. So, what is our coefficient? What was our coefficient? 3, 2, 0 and minus 1. This way. Keep some place in between 3 and 2, 2 and 0 and 0 and minus 1. Let's see how it has written. You can see here, this is your first row. In the first row, you have to write this minus 2, x plus 2. The opposite sign, is minus 2. So minus 2 will be right on the left of the vertical line as shown. Then coefficient of the coefficient form of the dividend polynomial is 3, 2, 0, minus 1 is written on the first row. All the things are written on the first row. Now we have to start the method. Okay. So write the first coefficient as it is in the third row. You can see this first coefficient is written as it is on the third row. Next step is, you can see here, first step is followed, second step is followed, third step is also followed. The next step is, just wait, zoom out. You can see 3 is written over here. This is your first coefficient and 3 should be multiplied by minus 2. You get minus 6 and this minus 6 should be written under 2. In the next, under the next coefficient, okay, that is 2. Now what you'll have to do here, 2, yahan pe humne kuch nahi kiya tha. 3 we have written as it is, okay. Now 2 minus 6 will become minus 4. 2 minus 6 as it is, you have to do the addition. So 2 minus 6 will become minus 4. So minus 4 you have to write here. Minus 4 again should be multiplied by 2. Minus 2, sorry. Will become plus 8. And this plus 8 you have to write next to your 6 or under your next coefficient, that is 0. 0 plus 8 will become plus 8. The next step, again 8 multiplied by minus 2 is minus 16. Then this minus 16 you have to write under minus 1, that is next coefficient. Minus 1 minus 16 will become, you say you have to write step by step, and minus 1 minus 16 will become minus 17. Similarly, by multiplying and adding last addition in the remainder, which is minus 17, and the coefficient form of the quotient is 3 minus 4 and plus 8. You can see here properly, yeh hamara multiplication method ho gaya. And here down we have got 3 minus 4 and minus plus 8. Aur yahan pe humko milta hai minus 17. Okay. This last minus 17 is your remainder. So your remainder is minus 17. Fine. And the coefficient form of the quotient. Coefficient form of the quotient is 3 minus 4 and plus 8. It should be written in the index form as 8 minus 4 and 3. So you will write 3x square minus 4x plus a. This is your quotient and this is your remainder. Fine. We'll see. It's correct. 3x square minus 4x plus 8 is your quotient and remainder is minus 17. So here you just have to write quotient and remainder as the question is asked. Divide the polynomial 3x cube plus 2x square minus 1 by x plus 2. So the in practice at 3.3, you can see divide each polynomial, each of the polynomial by synthetic division method and also by linear division method. So just don't have to do the linear division method. That is reduced from your portion. Just have to write. You just have to do synthetic division method. Okay. You can see on page number 46, one more question is there. Solved example is there. 2y raised to 4 minus 3y cube plus 5y minus 4 divided by y minus 1. So in the same way, you have to write dividend is here in standard form. 2y raised to 4 minus 3y cube plus 5y minus 4. So here 0y raised to 4 is was left. Okay. Now write opposite of minus 1 as plus 1 on the left of the vertical line in the first row. Okay. Write the coefficient form of your dividend in the first row. That is 2 minus 3, 0, 5 and minus 4. In this way, you can see here. Over here. Give the place in between all the coefficients. Write first coefficient as it is in the third row. Fine. Then multiply 2 with 1, you get 2. Write next, write it down to the next coefficient, minus 3. Minus 3 plus 2 will become minus 1. And this minus 1 multiplied by 1 is minus 1 again. Then 0 multiplied by 0 minus 1 will become minus 1 over here. And this minus 1 multiplied by 1 is minus 1 again. Then 5 minus 1 will become 4 over here. This 4 multiplied by 1 is 4 over here. This you have to write over here. Then minus 4 plus 4 will become 0. Okay. So your remainder is 0. And your quotient, coefficient form of quotient is 2 minus 1 minus 1 and 4. And it can be written as 2x cube, 2y cube minus y square minus y plus 4. And remainder is 0. So in our next lecture, we will do practice at 3.3 by using synthetic division method. And we will do it simultaneously with the other method also to get it cross-checked. Yes, Neha Gupta, you want to ask anything?